Well, we are here with the latest Golden Apple Award winner from Hoyt Middle School, Christine Hoffman. Christine, congratulations.
Thank you.
First off, tell me about your teaching career. How long have you been teaching?
I've been at Hoyt for 6 years. This is the only school I've been to.
And talk to me about your classroom. What all goes on in here?
So I work with kids with intellectual disabilities, so it's a small classroom. I have them for most of the day for language arts, math, science, but we're very close to our kids in my room, and we have a lot of fun, and I see them like as my kids too. I love them very much.
And it's a small classroom.
Yeah.
How many people are in your classroom?
So there are 4 students, mm-hmm. and then there's me and an associate.
Oh, wow. So really tight-knit in here.
Yes. We're like a family in here, for sure.
You know, talk to me about your job and the challenges you have. What does it take to teach in this classroom?
You really have to get to know the kids because they have all different learning levels, all different abilities, all different ways they prefer learning, communicating, and then like health needs. There's a lot that you need to know about each student and accommodating for those kids, but also making sure that you make learning fun for them too. And it can be a challenge with kids at such different levels. So there is a lot of just adjusting and planning that goes into just one student every day, on top of having to teach all the different subjects for the kids every day.
A lot of juggling then.
Yes, yeah.
Why did you want to become a teacher?
I wanted to become a teacher because I grew up with a sister with autism, and I knew I wanted to work with individuals with autism or disabilities, and so I decided teaching was that path for me. And once I got here and got this position, I knew that's where I belonged.
Sure. Why is it so important for you to want to teach students who may need extra help?
I feel like just like growing up with my sister with autism, I feel like I have like that special connection, and also with the families, because I know they have struggles at home and worries, and I am able to kind of share my experience growing up with my sister and the struggles we face, because it's not easy. And so I feel like I have a really good connection with the families and just have a better understanding of what goes on at school and at home.
What would you want others to know about that understanding and connection?
I would say that a lot of people maybe underestimate my kids and what they can do. They can do a lot more than what some believe they can do. So just to set high expectations for them, because they'll surprise you.
Sure. As she was reading off the list of qualities for this Golden Apple Award winner, what was going through your head? Did you ever think it was you?
Yeah, because she gave me warning that she was going to write it, and I was like, oh, okay, you can do that. I won't get chosen, but I typically in my mind, I'm like, oh, I wish I was recognized a little more. But then once I am recognized, I'm like, oh, my gosh, this is a lot, but it does feel good.
Yeah, talk about that, because a lot of times teachers do so much and don't get the recognition. So what is it like that you have this on the table for you?
I guess it builds up my confidence, because a lot of times I come in and there's a lot to do as a teacher, and it can be stressful. And I guess it just shows that like what I'm doing is enough, and that I am doing a good job.
Making a difference.
Yeah.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I'm just really grateful for being recognized, and that I'm just really proud of the kids that I have and love them very much. And I'm excited to tell them about what I've earned, and just to tell them about it. So I think they'll be really excited.
Well, congratulations. Very well deserved.
Thank you.